That's what grace is. Grace is just the goodness and the favor of God. Grace is not just limited to God. We can show grace to each other. We can show an undeserved favor towards somebody else. That's what grace is. And what God is saying to us here is that I've given you everything, and all of the things I've given you in your spiritual life, not just physically, but spiritually, it's all because I'm gracious to you. And so that's the thought for today, that grace gave us everything. And I want you to notice with me in verse number 7, the first thing that grace gave us, God's riches and goodness and favor and blessing in our life. This is the first thing that Paul says in verse 7, in whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sins according to the riches of his grace. You know what grace gave us? Grace first and foremost gave us the fact that we've been forgiven. It was because of grace that we've been forgiven. As you sit here today and you're watching this, you need to be thinking about your life. First of all, if you're a Christian, if you know that you put your faith in Jesus Christ, just meditate for a minute and think about the fact that it was God's favor and goodness to you. It was the blessing and riches of his grace that enabled you and allowed you to be forgiven of your sin. That's what he's saying. It's grace that provided the way. The way for us to have access to God is because of God's grace and favor toward us. I love what Paul said to Titus in that book. In Titus in chapter 2, he said, for the grace of God that bringeth salvation hath appeared to all men. The first part of that, the grace of God that brings salvation. In other words, it was only because God decided to bestow his favor and his grace toward mankind that we could have access to the salvation that only God can offer us. The grace of God that brings salvation. And it's God reminding us of the fact that we are forgiven and the access to having the ability to have ourselves forgiven from God is because of his grace that's in our life. Again, that passage in Ephesians 2, this is very familiar for many of us. For by grace are you saved through faith. And that not of yourselves, it's a gift of God, right? For by grace are you saved. Grace, that's God giving us what we don't deserve just because he's a wonderful and good God. So he bestows his grace. That grace provides the way for us to be saved. Grace provides the way, the undeserved favor of God. You know, when you think about the many cults and false religions of our world, there's some of them that wear the badge of Christianity, don't they? Oh, they claim to be Christian in some regard. They may have a Bible of some sort that they carry around, and they may have many of the methodologies that true believers have. But just because they say a certain thing or even act a certain way does not mean that they're correct in their theology or they're correct in their doctrine. And these cults and false religions, even some that claim to be Christianized or Christian in some way, if they promote a works salvation, you've got to do this in order to have favor with God. You've got to be a good person, do enough good works, live a pure enough or clean enough life, deny yourself enough things in life, whatever the case might be. Those cults and false religions that teach that, they make a liar out of God. They make a liar out of the Word of God, because the Bible itself is very clear. We don't need to find a way to interpret what God says, brethren. We need to believe what God says. And God made it very clear. He said in the book of Romans in chapter 3 that we have been justified freely by his grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. We have been justified, in other words, declared to be just by God. He said freely by the grace of God. That's the truth of the Word of God. And that's the marvel of God's grace, that it wasn't something we deserved, and it was given to us very freely. It provided the way for us to be saved. So it's not of our works. It's not of our goodness. It's not of any good thing you could do.